हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम टू इंग्लिश ग्रामर कैफे. सी आई हैव टू सेंटेंसेस फॉर यू. ही हेल्प्ड हिमसेल्फ एंड ही हिमसेल्फ हेल्प्ड मी. कैन यू टेल मी व्हाट्स द डिफरेंस बिटवीन दीज टू सेंटेंसेस. एक्चुअली दीज टू सेंटेंसेस आर एब्सोल्युटली डिफरेंट. व्हेन आई से ही हेल्प्ड हिमसेल्फ मीन्स उसने खुद की मदद की. मीन्स He had a problem and he got the solution. And when I say he himself helped me, means उसने खुद मेरी मदद की. I did not say to him to help me. So in the first sentence, when I say he helped himself, here himself is reflexive pronoun. And when I say he himself helped me, here himself is emphatic pronoun. So today we are going to learn what's the difference between reflexive pronoun and emphatic pronoun, how to use them and where to use them. And at the end of the video there is a quiz. Make sure you take it to check your learning and understanding. But before starting our lesson, I would like you to subscribe my channel and don't forget to hit the bell icon to get notification for each new lesson. Now let's start today's lesson. Reflexive pronoun. What are the reflexive pronouns? Reflexive pronouns are used when the action of the subject turns back on the subject itself. They are mostly used as object of the verb. And these reflexive pronouns are myself, ourselves, himself, herself, themselves, yourself, yourselves, oneself, and itself. You must have noticed that I have said yourself and yourselves. See, these are two different words and it is essential to learn the difference between these two words. See, yourself is used in singular sense. When I'm talking to one person, I will say, you do it yourself. And when I have a class in front of me, when I have many students in front of me, what will I say? I'll say, all of you have to do your work yourselves. Means when you is used as a single person, yourself. And when we use you as plural, for many people, we use yourselves. I hope it's clear. Let's understand reflexive pronouns with some examples. Example number one. The dog looked at itself in the mirror. Dog ne khud ko mirror mein dekha. So here you can see itself is working here as an object. Dog ne kise dekha? Khud ko. So dog is subject and itself is an object. Means action is running back on the subject. Next one, he hurt himself. Usne khud ko hurt kiya. Usne kise hurt kiya? Himself, khud ko. So here also you can see that action is turning back on the subject itself. He is a subject and himself is an object. Next one, she blamed herself. उसने खुद को ही दोषी ठहराया. उसने दोषी ठहराया. उसने किसे दोषी ठहराया? Herself, खुद को. So herself is an object. So here also action is turning back on the subject. So herself, reflexive pronoun. Next one, I made myself a bowl of pasta. मैंने अपने लिए पास्ता बनाया. So here also action is turning back on the subject. मैंने बनाया किसके लिए? खुद के लिए. So here you must have noticed one thing that in all these sentences, reflexive pronouns are placed just after the verb or at the end of the sentence. So here that is the tip for you that reflexive pronouns are placed after the verb or at the end of the sentence. What are emphatic pronouns? Emphatic pronouns emphasize the subjects they refer to. Means जब हम एम्फेटिक प्रोनाउंस यूज करते हैं तब हम उस सब्जेक्ट पर ज़्यादा जोर देते हैं। एंड एम्फेटिक प्रोनाउंस आर जस्ट द सेम एज रिफ्लेक्सिव प्रोनाउंस, मीन्स दे आर हिमसेल्फ, हरसेल्फ, देमसेल्फ्स, माईसेल्फ, आरसेल्फ्स, योरसेल्फ एंड योरसेल्फ्स। नाउ लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड एम्फेटिक प्रोनाउंस विद एग्जाम्पल्स। एग्जाम्पल नंबर वन, दे themselves decided to end their quarrel. उन्होंने खुद अपना झगड़ा खत्म करने का निर्णय लिया। Means no one told them to do so. Next one, I myself cleaned the table. Means no one told me to do so. I myself, मैंने खुद टेबल क्लीन की, मुझे किसी ने बोला नहीं ऐसा करने के लिए। Next one, she herself admitted her mistake. उसने खुद अपनी गलती स्वीकार की। शी herself, नो वन टोल्ड हर टू डू सो, शी herself डिसाइडेड। आई myself डिड दिस वर्क, मीन्स आई myself डिड इट, मैंने खुद ये किया। नो वन टोल्ड मी टू डू सो, नो वन helped मी, आई myself डिड इट। नेक्स्ट वन, He himself agreed to organize the party. He himself agreed, वो खुद तैयार हुआ। No one forced him, no one told him to do so. He himself agreed to organize the party. You must have noticed one thing in all these sentences, that emphatic pronouns are just after the subject. So that's the tip for you, that emphatic pronouns are always placed just after the subject. He himself, she herself, you yourself, I myself. So this way we use all these emphatic pronouns. Reflexive pronouns are used as objects of the verb. And emphatic pronoun, they just lay stress on the subject itself. I hope today reflexive pronoun and emphatic pronouns are clear to you and you have a better understanding about these two kinds of pronouns and their meanings also. Now here I have a quiz for you, and just make sure that you yourself do it. Here is the quiz. Here are the answers. Excellent. Now it's your turn to hit the like button and share it with your friends to help them. Now let's meet in the next video. Till then, bye.